This. I have to call this a success. These engines to be perfect. Got my helper here as usual. No, looks like he might be off. Right, let's rip into this.
We're getting close to getting this exactly where I want it to be. All those things that make it run at the speed, the sound, the coolness that I want. I love that process. I love that I get an engine that works, that's fine the way it is, and I can work on that process and enjoy doing so. On this engine so far, we've changed the ignition point to just after top dead center, which really helps when these are at that slow point that they get down to in the miss, where they then need to fire again at such slow RPMs.
You can see down there where I've advanced that to. It's on an angle, taking the hall sensor a little bit further this way as this wheel comes around. It's delaying the ignition a little bit just after top dead center.
I've changed the spring purely by stretching it out till it was overstretched and then lopping bits off to get it to the point where it was loose enough that it still rotated through the compression to fire. Put a tiny little lever, which I turned from a little rod of brass on my drill press. I don't have a lathe. That's really helpful when just trying to get that exact point where that fires reliably, which you really need if you're running this really slow. I've started to hear a knocking. after you know, the five or so runs I've done, and that's normal for these engines. With a brass conrod, the little end of the conrod doesn't always fit the pin that goes across the piston. And I've tried to pack a little bit of aluminium foil in that.
Happy with that. So we've got that securely wedged under there. Now we're going to clean this rod a bit. We're going to get the pin, clean that a bit. Okay, so that wiggles quite a bit in there.
Blue tack's possibly not the best, but it's what I've got.
Right, we're going to try not to set fire to everything. But if we do, you guys call the fire brigade, please. And we need that to be straight. That big end's going to be cold. This little end is going to be hot, because I'm going to blast with this. I need to wet some paper. Get ready with some wet paper to quench that. Right, let's blast this with fire. That's all the fun bit, isn't it? Now, I can't even see my flame, so I'm... Oh, there we go. I can well and truly see it now. I'm going to have to try and not burn everything in the house. That's always a good idea, not burning everything in the house. Going to use these here. The idea is to get this a lot softer than the stuff down the bottom, so I'm not damaging anything. Now we've got a pin that is exactly a I'd have to give that a wee polish, actually. It's such an exact fit. Right. Which is, you know, that's, I reckon that's going to cut down a little bit of wobbly noise there, which is what we want. Yeah, that goes in there just fine. You really want to clean up. Oh, that's going in. Great. You really want to clean up any of this grease so it doesn't get in the bore, because it'll slow you down. So that's not going to wiggle back and forth. We need it in the middle. And I would say that's in the middle. How much wiggle have we got? We've still got some wiggle, but we got no back and forth. We've got no back and forth like this. Very little side wiggle and no back and forth. So that's exactly what I wanted. You might say, Thomas, that's a hell of a hassle for nothing. But look, it's not for nothing. I got to show you guys what I've just tried to do, and you can decide whether it's a waste of time or not. We're going to run the engine. We're going to see whether it seems to have benefited from that or not. And this time, because I believe I'm on my final disassembly, I am going to use Loctite on the screws that hold in my sliding latch. There you are, dropping screws. So I'll teach you guys how to say in Chinese, "Oh my gosh, that's frustrating." And you just go, "Aiya," like that. As you know, I'm part Chinese by marriage, and that's probably the first thing and the most useful thing I've learned. And it's universally recognized in Asia, which is even better. It's not just Chinese. I think you can go, "Aiya," at anyone and they will know you're frustrated. Okay, that's it. Very natural sort of a sound to make too, you know, onomatopoeic. Right, we're getting there though. I don't need to be frustrated. I need this little, where are you, tweezers? Come to me. Everybody with sausage fingers needs a pair of tweezers, so I was first in the queue, as you can imagine. Okay.
Possibly the main thing for me was working on the latch, the hit and miss detent latch that goes across and holds the exhaust valve open so this can go through its miss cycle.
And obviously we like it to miss, do a nice long miss and run as cool as possible.
To start with, I turned that latch around 45 degrees, and then yesterday I moved that very, very slightly, and I think I've perfected where I want that latch to be. It's got hardly any lift. I haven't yet changed the exhaust spring, which could be lighter. I don't think that's so important if you have the latch perfect. Yesterday I had a little bit of trouble with the spark sparking in the base rather than the engine. I may have to clean some grease off of that. Actually, it is still a bit greasy, so I think I might do that. Yeah, ever since Elmo, I haven't minded if my favourite toy does something unexpected.
That tickles! Now lick my nipples!
What?
Hopefully not as traumatising as the Elmo experience was, but yeah. Love working on these things, and we're going to perfect this and give it a run.
I want this face here that looks like it's at 45 degrees. That should be at 90 degrees, and the other one should be at 45 degrees. Okay, here we go. So you're not going to see the bit that I've heated and turned on the end. You can see it's been turned though. We're going to see how that goes. I've moved that edge, which is on the top of your screen, that edge of the hit and miss, closer. I've moved it that way, closer to the top of the screen. Let's see how we go. I don't expect this to be like this from the factory. That is barely moving, that latch. Just barely moving. It's a nice speed. That's a little bit faster than it was. I just tightened up the spring a little bit. That is really nice. I don't think I need to mess with the exhaust valve spring, which was all the compression, which are two other things that people suggested. A pretty good long miss cycle there. We are getting a little bit of spark, not quite getting to the spark plug, but it seems to be alright right now. We'll fix that if it becomes a problem. And the little end of the conrod, not too loud right now. I can definitely still hear it knocking. Hey, what do you think of that? Hmm?